Lisa with BTV and Entertainment News. There's five categories I would like to introduce you, which are movies, music, TV shows, games, and celebrity news. Number one, movies. There's a latest movie that's going to come out on March 25th of 2020, which is called Mulan. And many film producer has predicted that it's going to make about $150 million in the future. And
my reflection can only show me as I appear. But not as who I am. The path that was woven for me has begun to unravel. My destiny's uncertain.
We're going to make men out of every single one of you.
Patience to ensure the true aim finds the true target.
It is my duty to protect my family.
Is there something to which I am not aware?
War is how this will end.
Close the gate!
The top eight ranked Disney animated soundtracks. There's actually eight. Number one, Lion King. Number two, Hercules. Number three, Beauty and the Beast. Number four, Pocahontas. Number five, Aladdin. Number six, The Little Mermaid. Number seven, Tarzan. And number eight, Moana. There's some TV shows that you might want to watch. Two of the most popular, which is aired only on Disney Channel. Number one is Rapunzel's Tangled Adventure, which airs only on Disney Channel on Sundays at 7:30 p.m. East Pacific Time. And also, don't forget about Big Hero 5, which airs on the weekend at 8:30 p.m. East Pacific Time. And don't forget about America's Got Talent, which my husband and I was really lucky to be able to be on the show as on-camera audience in 2016 and at Pasadena Civic Auditorium. One of my favorite judges is most definitely Heidi Klum, the host from Project Runway, and David Hasselhoff from Baywatch. You can totally download games. This is a Disney game. It only costs about $9.99 to download on the Apple Play Store. Okay, so feel free to download this. This is called Kim Possible / Mission Improbable. I want to share with you some celebrity news. Okay, number one on the list is, ever heard of this headline called Meghan and Harry versus the royal family? Pick a side. Well, basically, you've probably heard of Prince Harry finding the love of his life when he traveled to America to meet the American actress Meghan. They have one little baby that's a little bit over than 1 year old that they decided to move to Canada and start their own life and become independent from the royal family. So they want to be separated from the royal family. So basically, give me your comments and your thought below. Let me know if you support their decision in trying to become more independent, or do you support Queen Elizabeth? Queen Elizabeth wants the royal family to stick together.
The new fallout following Prince Harry and Meghan Markle's announcement. The Queen, not happy, said to be hosting crisis talks next week to find a solution. ABC's Julia McFarlane is at the palace tonight.
Tonight, the monarchy in crisis mode. A palace source telling ABC News the Queen will host a summit at her Sandringham estate on Monday to decide the future of Harry, Meghan and their role in the royal family. Her Majesty will meet with Prince Charles, Prince William and Prince Harry to discuss, quote, a range of possibilities.
This will be the first time that Harry comes face to face with his three family members. Meghan's expected to join via phone.
Harry and Meghan defied the Queen with that bombshell announcement that they wanted to step back as senior royals. The Queen, seen driving yesterday, wants this handled quickly, in days, not weeks.
She wants to show the nation that she has a handle on this situation, but it's also important for them to really please Harry and Meghan because they're clearly very unhappy.
One major topic, the issue of money. Harry and Meghan say they will work to become financially independent. They reportedly intend to give up their taxpayer-funded allowance, but whether Prince Charles, who provides the bulk of their money, will continue to fund the couple remains to be seen. Since Harry and Meghan outlined their hopes to split their time between the UK and North America, both the British and the Canadian governments are being consulted as part of the ongoing negotiations. The cost of their security and who pays likely high on the agenda.
So comment below and let me know about your thoughts. All right, number two on the agenda is Cameron Diaz. She's already 47 years old. Word had it that she's been pregnant. So, you probably know the really famous movie that got her into stardom called There's Something About Mary. It was released in 1998. And right now, we're checking out There's Something About Reddix, which is their new baby girl, which was born on December 30th, 2019. Okay, so this is magnificent news that everyone found out that she got pregnant through a surrogate.
I never say never to anything, believe me.
Babies included, because surprise, Cameron Diaz and Benji Madden just welcomed a baby girl.
Yeah!
On Friday, the couple announced the news on Instagram, sharing this message that read in part, quote, "We are so happy, blessed, and grateful to begin this new decade by announcing the birth of our daughter, Reddix Madden. She has instantly captured our hearts and completed our family." Cameron and Benji also explained that they have no plans to share any pictures of their little one and won't be giving any more details about her in order to protect her privacy. But they did add that their sweet bundle of joy is, quote, really, really cute. Some would even say rad. The actress and the rocker tied the knot in 2015 in a private ceremony.
I'm just grateful for, you know, my family, my friends, my health. Those are really the most important things, you know.
Since then, the two have stayed tight-lipped about their love. But the 47-year-old was unusually candid about her marriage in a rare interview with InStyle magazine in 2019, calling getting married the best thing that ever happened to me. She also called Benji the greatest human being and my great partner. She added, quote, "Marriage is certainly hard, and it's a lot of work. You need somebody who's willing to do the work with you, because there's no 60-40 in marriage. It's 50-50, period. All the time." Cameron admitted that she didn't know if she was ready to get married when she did, but she knew that Benji was special.
My motto is gratitude's the only attitude, and I live that every day.
And Carmen Diaz herself has personally admitted that they have been trying to get pregnant for over a year through IVF, acupuncture, and vitamin supplements. So finally, they get to have a baby girl of their own. So congratulations to the maidens. Okay, the last but not least, another news is about Kate Middleton and Prince William, which they're preparing for their throne. They're gonna be crowned king and queen anytime soon.
Kate Middleton, Prince William are reportedly preparing for the throne every day after receiving praise for recent documentary The Duke and Duchess of Cambridge. Kate Middleton and Prince William have certainly become the next king and queen of the United Kingdom. While this will only happen after Prince Charles's reign, reports were claiming the royal couple is now being prepared to take the responsibilities. Many are certain that Kate and William are now somehow ready for their future titles. Such comments have become apparent when sources told People magazine that Duke and Duchess definitely stole the spotlight from the much more senior royals during the recent royal event. As described by the source, Kate Middleton and Prince William are gracious and natural, They combine grace and regal presence, and yet they can still connect to the people that surround them. Accordingly, it is no wonder why so many people agree that the Duke and Duchess are now ready to take more responsibility for the monarchy. Royal expert and biographer Ingrid Seward also shared the same thoughts about the Cambridge couple. As per Fox News, she claimed that the Duke and Duchess are being prepared every day for the throne.
This report is reported by Cosmopolitan with Hearst Magazine Media. Thanks for watching. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up, and feel free to subscribe to the website or to take a look and come like my page, which is Bill and Nick's Paradise. All right, thanks for watching.